SCP-3959 James, that terminal in 362, sub-level 6 is still locked. Why we even have an unregistered personal computer in O1 is beyond me, and it needs to be addressed. Seriously though, get someone from IT down here and take care of it. We are the largest data reliquary for the entire Foundation. We don't need anything to go wrong here. Fix it. Site Director A. Philip Saudry, sent one of the techs down there the other day, said the computer was locked with level 5 multi-factor authentication. What the hell is it doing down there? If the data on there is so highly sensitive, no one would have just signed off on leaving where it was. I honestly would have just tossed the thing. Just keep it running for now. It isn't hurting anyone. Senior researcher J. Harkness Audrey went poking around on the device's hard drive. Most of it is heavily encrypted, but I managed to find a few files. I found some documentation for a SCP-3959, looks stated. Timestamp says it's around 7 years old. Hadn't been accessed in 5. Next time you are free, cross-reference these files with the ones stored on our backup just to be safe. Senior Researcher J. Harkness Attachment CD. Item Hash, SCP-3959 Object Class, Euclid Special Containment Procedures. Members of Mobile Task Force Capitan, Skynet, are assigned the task of tracking SCP-3959. All personnel assigned to the study of SCP-3959 must score above a 40 on the Anomalous Cognition Resistance Scale, see Addendum 3959-11A. Due to the nature of the anomaly, containment is nearly impossible, albeit unnecessary, as SCP-3959 tends to locate itself within close vicinity of Foundation servers. Specifically those of Site 01, the facility responsible for the backup of all archived data. Despite this, effective means of containing SCP-3959 should be implemented as soon as possible. At no time should material affected by SCP-3959 make contact with any sensitive data or media that might help facilitate an external breach of Foundation property. All backup data at Site 01 must be checked for inconsistencies daily by a group of assigned individuals with Level 5 clearance. Description: SCP-3959 is the designation for an autonomous cognitohazard that can exist within any form of communication medium. It has been shown to occupy a wide variety of objects, such as a website, a desktop placard and a radio broadcast. See Experiment Log 3959-11A for more information. SCP-3959 is presumed to have infervorous tendencies, and therefore gravitates towards large amounts of data, particularly non-fiction works. SCP-3959 is capable of transferring itself onto any media directly facing or in contact with the current host 1. When SCP-3959 finds a suitable host medium, it will transfer itself, regardless of distance. Any media that is currently in contact with SCP-3959 will start to automatically redact its own information over a period of time that is directly proportional to its own complexity. Most information is obscured by standard full block Unicode, although other methods have been recorded. This is considered SCP-3959 feeding. If left undeterred, SCP-3959 will not stop this process until all information present is obscured and irretrievable. SCP-3959 shows remarkable intelligence and has been able to access digital software with relative ease, bypassing many security restrictions and potentially compromising sections of Site-01's databases. It is assumed that SCP-3959 is able to freely access and travel through the Internet if it is available. Therefore, Site-01's servers must be located on an off-grid private server network. Encryption and tight restriction of information going in and out of Site-01 has successfully deterred SCP-3959 from breaching Foundation servers any further. Addendum 3959-11A. After multiple reports of confusion and fogginess from personnel working with SCP-3959, it has been deduced that viewing or interacting with the anomaly poses a mild cognitohazardous threat to sentient life. Those with high cognitive resistance seem to be immune to this effect. The vector by which SCP-3959 affects the brain and information in general is still being researched. CD. Experiment Log 3959-11A Experiment Log Format, Provided Materials, Results, Notes, Name, Dr. Mikhail, Senior Researcher Aberdeen Campbell Date of Testing, //1997 Note, This will be the first test of SCP-3959's abilities. Due to its resistance to containment and potential harm to Foundation archives, these experiments were carried out in a room with a single lane-only computer. 3959 was lured onto a flash drive containing miscellaneous textbooks and transported on-site. Provided materials. 1. Music album, inserted into CD drive of computer results. SCP-3959 preferred the textbook content over the album. After the textbooks were completely redacted, hours later, SCP-3959 successfully latched onto the CD. Data on the disk slowly corrupted over time. Minutes later, the CD was completely unplayable and was removed from the computer. Upon removal, CD label was found to be redacted, as well as the cover of the CD case, which was not intended. Note: SCP-3959's transfer and corruption is very adaptive. It shows preference to denser, more literal forms of information, but will not ignore other data if it is available. Dr. Mikhail provided materials. 1. Painting, shown to SCP-3959 results. SCP-3959 immediately jumped to the painting and consumed it with a black pigmentation within 5 minutes. 3959 transferred back onto the computer shortly afterwards. Sample of canvas was taken to lab to be analyzed. Note, it is unknown whether SCP-3959 requires information as sustenance, or is simply acting out of compulsion. Lab analysis revealed the black dye to be indistinguishable from the canvas. Researcher Campbell provided materials. 1. FM radio, set to .com is shown to SCP-3959 results. SCP-3959 did not react at first, but transferred once the station host began to talk. Over a period of 15 minutes, SCP-3959 consumed the broadcast until it degraded to static. Station was unable to be picked up on other radios in the testing area. SCP-3959 considered to have left the containment chamber. MTF Caperton initialized for reconnaissance of anomaly. Note, probably should have seen that one coming. Testing concluded for today. Dr. Mikhail, SCP-3959 was detected 12 hours later, attempting to gain access to Site-01 via researcher's cell phone. Phone was placed on airplane mode and brought to testing area. Was reprimanded for bringing an unauthorized device on site. Provided materials. 1. DVD film, shown to SCP-3959 via television. Results. 3959 did not leave the cell phone until it was unusable, having redacted parts of its own registry. Upon latching onto the film, quality of the material began to deteriorate. After 7 minutes, film was unwatchable. After SCP-3959 was transferred to a new device, DVD label found to be completely redacted. Clock on DVD player read : permanently. Note, later analysis shows that some of the labels on internal components inside the television have redactions on them as well. What is the limit of this thing? Researcher Campbell provided materials. 1. Mirror, shown to SCP-3959 results. Note, James, SCP-3959 doesn't exist yet. Had to double check just to be sure. It is possible it got reassigned, but I have been unable to locate any matches as of now. I'm going to pull up a staff directory. Hopefully I can find one of the two that worked on the research team and have them clarify it for me. Just keep an eye on that terminal. Site Director A. Phillips Audrey, sounds good. Try to find that researcher Campbell. Looking through email archives has brought up little, but I did manage to find these. I poke around more, but I'm pretty sure I'm breaking enough policy as it is. Let me know what you make of it. Senior Researcher J. Harkness Attachment Cyberdean, I don't know what you guys are cooking up over there in O1, but these requests are a bit unethical. You know how these systems work. You can't just force something to metastasize and expect it to work under your conditions. I'll be alerting Overwatch about this. Hope you know what you're getting yourself into. Beatrip, Overwatch is heading Project Callisto. I think they know what they are doing. Feel free to tell them off though, see where that gets you. Abby Researcher Campbell, your request to utilize SCP for Project Callisto has been granted. You have the full support of the Council of 57 James, this is too weird. I found Campbell and asked her about 3959 nothing. No clue what I was talking about. She was telling the truth. I have no records of this anomaly. No records of a Project Callisto. I think it's time we got Overwatch involved. Saraswati 3959 footnotes 1. Contact being defined as anything capable of receiving stimulus from SCP-3959 affected works. For example, radio waves can carry 3959 to another device capable of picking it up, but it will not spread to, say, a piece of literature.